Risk reduction. Establishing and implementing an office policy. There are several crime prevention organizations that specialize specifically in agent safety. At least two organizations are affiliated with the National Association of Realtors. Further, risk reduction is a timely topic both at NAR and with individual organizations around the country. The broker manager must take proactive steps to ensure a strict office policy is in place, updated annually or more often, and find a way to instruct agents and staff about the policy. Buyers and sellers' liability. The greatest measure to lessen liability for buyers and sellers is through education. Making sure that your principal not only signs the contracts, but understands what they mean. It's often helpful to create a list or roadmap of the purchase or sales process so that you can walk them through it, alerting them to responsibilities that they may currently be unaware of. While disclosure tends to be the biggest concern in most situations, there are times when a buyer could also be liable. For example, if a buyer decides to take possession of the property before settlement, and then something were to cause the transaction to fail, the buyer would be held liable for any damages that occurred while he was there without permission. Incident follow-up. Any time an incident occurs, depending on what it is and who was involved, some sort of follow-up plan should be in place and executed. Incidents might include physical harm, professional conduct concerns, or conflicted communications. Follow-up should include dates, times, and updates pertinent to the incident. Any parties with a vested interest to the incident should be kept appraised of any results or developments that may concern them. Brokers and agents' responsibility. As noted earlier, brokers and agents have a great deal of responsibility. Clearly, the broker carries the heavier burden because he or she is ultimately held responsible for the actions of his or her agents. Obviously, if an agent commits gross negligence or assault, the broker may seem to be left without liability, but that isn't necessarily always the case. Basically, an agent acts on the behalf of the broker. So, let's say, for example, an agent strikes a client without justification. That assault may end in the agent's arrest. While the broker would likely not hold any criminal liability, that is not to say that the client could not sue the agent and broker in a civil lawsuit. In that example, the broker's liability insurance would most likely protect the broker, but not the agent. With licensed agents, the liabilities to be aware of revolve around disclosures, ethics, and discrimination. There, of course, may be other areas, such as criminal conduct or fraud, but for the most part, those are the three areas where most licensees face liability issues. While most non-intentional acts will be covered by the agent's liability insurance, criminal acts or gross misconduct usually won't. Even if an agent is considered liable for a certain act that was not deemed illegal, the agent may still stand to lose his license or have it suspended. Continuing education classes, even beyond those that are required, are one good way that agents can keep themselves up to date on new laws, policies, and codes. It's also important to keep up to date with contract changes and local ordinances that can and do affect your transactions. Agent safety begins with awareness and prevention. Brokers should take a proactive role in setting office policies that are required learning for the agents. And agents must be diligent in exercising not only common sense, but going beyond common sense and embracing safety and prevention as an ongoing part of their daily practices.